Are y'all happy to be in the house of the Lord? Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm so excited. My wife and I are here tonight with you once again, Pastor Ann and myself, and we're so glad to be here. Would you just lift up your hands? I'm going to ask Pastor Adam to just lead us in prayer right now, and we want to welcome the Spirit of God as we go into praise. Amen. Go
ahead, Pastor. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence here, Lord. We thank you for all that you have for us tonight. We press into that. We press into your presence, and we come into your presence with thanksgiving and praise. We honor you. You said those who honor you, you will honor with your presence, with your goodness. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. We honor you. Do what you want to do. Move how you want to move. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Are y'all ready to sing unto the Lord? Amen. Here we go. Sing, 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 and make music with the heavens. We will sing, sing, sing. Grateful that you hear us when we shout your praise. Lift high the name of Jesus. What's not to love about you? Heaven and earth adore you. Kings and kingdoms bow down. Son of God, you are the word. You are the one we're living for. You are the love that frees us. You are the light that leads us, like a fire burning. Son of God, you are the Word. You are the Word we're living for. Sing, 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 and make music with the heavens. We will sing, sing, sing. And we're grateful that you hear us when we shout your praise. Lift high the name of Jesus.
How many of y'all can praise him with a hope and heart tonight?
What's not to love about you? Heaven and earth adore you. Kings and kingdoms bow down. Son of God, you are the one. You are the one we're living for. Sing, 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 and make music with the heavens. We will sing, 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 and we're grateful that you hear us when I shout your praise. Higher than
ever. Sing it again.
Come, sing, 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 and make music with the heavens. We will sing, 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 and we're grateful that you hear us when we shout your praise. Higher the name of Jesus. That you hear us with a shout of your praise. Lift high the name of Jesus.
Sing, sing, sing,
and make music with the heavens. We will sing, 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 and we're grateful that you hear us when we shout your praise. Lift high the name of Jesus.
Somebody shout the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, he's worthy. Amen. Give him praise tonight. Hallelujah to the
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Magnify.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody say, thank you, Lord God. You're so good.
Thank you.
Amen,
Lord.
And amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. How many of you know that if it wasn't for the resurrection power of Christ, we would all still be in a tomb somewhere? Oh, come on, somebody. I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. How many of you glad you met Jesus? Amen.
Amen.
I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my tomb till I met you.
Woo!
You called my name and I ran out of that grave.
Hey!
Out of the darkness into your glorious day. My name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Hey,
somebody give him a shout of praise. Now your mercy has saved my soul, and now your freedom is all that I know.
Yes, Lord.
The old made new when I met you. 'Cause when you call my name,
come on,
I ran out of that grave.
Hey.
Out of the darkness into your glorious day. You call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Come on, let's say it again.
You call my name, and I ran out of that grave,
yeah.
Out of the darkness into your glorious day. Call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Yay! Come on, give them a shout of praise.
Oh,
yeah. Say, that's my testimony, amen.
Yeah.
Jesus gave me life, and life more abundantly. Listen, listen, listen.
My sin was heavy, chain break in the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, and now you call me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing, and now your love is the air that I breathe. I have a future, my eyes are open,
and
when you call my name,
yeah.
Out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Yes.
You called my name and I ran out of that grave. Out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Come on, can we do that bridge one more time? I want you to testify it. If you can read it, come on, read it with me. Say,
I needed rescue. My sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter. I was an orphan, and now you call me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing, and now your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future. My eyes are open. So when you call my name, you call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day.
Hallelujah.
You call my name,
shout it out now,
and I ran out of that grave.
Yeah.
Out of the darkness, into your glorious day. You call my name, and I ran out of that grave. Yeah. Out of the darkness, into your glorious day.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, glorious day.
Glory.
Woo. Yes, it was a glorious
Hallelujah.
Day. Come on, Lord, we give you praise in this house. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. How many of you know that when you praise him, you create an atmosphere. An atmosphere that gives him the freedom to move and to do great and mighty things. The Spirit of God is in this house. Come on, lift up your hands right now. And I want you to declare in the mighty name of Jesus and say, Lord, you have your way tonight. You come and have your way. You come and have your way. My life praises you. My heart worships you. My mouth gives you glory. My mind gives you glory. Everything about me, Lord, surrenders to you. And we invite you, Lord, to come and be free in this house tonight. Oh, I wish I had somebody who was hungry for his presence. I wish I had somebody who was hungry and too ready to lift up the name of the living God. Oh, somebody give him glory. He's worthy. Ain't no God like our God. Oh, shadadamama, shadadadabade. Hallelujah. How many of you know that our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against the powers and principalities of this world? The Lord has called us his own. And because we are his own, we have been equipped with the mighty power of his word. You can speak those things that are not as if they were. Call those things that are not as if they were. I'm telling you right now, there is power in your praise. There's power in your worship. This is the opportunity that God is bringing you right now to declare those things in your life that are not as if they were. Come on, lift up your praise to the Lord. Say, Lord, I believe in your word. I believe, Lord God, in what you said. And I believe that with one word, you can change my atmosphere. You can change my circumstance. You can change my situation. Oh, I wish I had some people of faith in this place. Somebody with a little faith. The faith the size of a mustard seed. You could speak to a mountain and it would cast itself into the sea. Oh, you see, this is how I fight my battles.
This is how
I say. Because this is how I fight my battles. I use the word of God, the word of God, the word of God. Then this is how I fight my battles. Now I fight my battle. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded.
surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. I see your angels. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
This is how I fight the battle.
Oh, somebody help me say that right now. This is how.
This is how I fight my battle. Oh,
my heart worships you. My heart praises you. Say,
this is how I fight my battle.
Oh, I'm not fighting against bone. I'm not fighting against flesh. Oh,
this is how I fight my battle.
Come on, say, Jesus, open my eyes. I want to see your angels tonight. Hey,
it may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Come on, transfer in.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. This is how I fight my battle. This is how I fight my battle.
This is how I fight my battle. I fight my battle.
This is how I fight my battle.
I want you to hear this.
Let it rain. Let it rain. Gates of heaven, let it rain, let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven, let it rain, let it rain.
Child of God, I
help me say, child of God. Come on, declare it over yourself. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Because He
as you can tonight. Father, we welcome you into this place. We worship you and glorify you. We exalt your holy name. Holy Spirit, come and have your way tonight. Lord, your people are hungry for you. Your people are thirsty for you. Come, Lord. Come, Lord, and fill their hearts. Come, Lord, and fill this place. Break down every imagination against the knowledge of Christ. Come and minister and speak into the hearts of your children. Let them know, Lord God, your heart for them. Some of them are broken, Lord. Some of them are feeling lonely. Some of them are hurting tonight. Some of them are perplexed with questions that they have no answers to. Lord, we know that you are the solution. You are the resolve, Lord God. You're the answer that to everything that we need. Lord, tonight we lift up holy hands before you as a sign of surrender. Our praise, Lord God, dictates our heart and our hunger for you, Lord. Come and fill this place. Come and move in this house. Lord, we're tired of the same old, we're tired, Lord God, of the same old, we need a mighty move from God, we need the Spirit of the Lord to descend into this house with fire. I wish I had some hungry people here tonight that could say, I need
need just a little more tonight. I need more of His presence. I need more of His word. I need a move of God. I need my heart to be jump-started one more time. I need my spirit to be recharged and regenerated. I need the Lord to speak life into me. Oh, Jesus, come, 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 come. Holy Spirit, come, 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 come. Come on, call on Him right now. Call on Him right now. Call on Him right now. If you've been filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost, then loose those tongues. I said loose those tongues. Let the Spirit of God begin to move through you. Create an atmosphere. Create an atmosphere. Create an atmosphere. I wanted you to know tonight, the devil is a lie. And everything he's been telling you all week long has been nothing but one lie after the other. You see, you are made for greatness. You are made to be awesome. You were made to succeed and not to fail. You've been made, hallelujah, to do great and mighty things in the name of the Lord. Low self-esteem is not from God. Hurting hearts are not God's plan for you. Oh, He has good thoughts. He's got a good thing waiting for you. If you'll only just call on His name, He says He will answer and He will show up. Will somebody just say the name of Jesus? Just say the name of Jesus. We welcome You, Lord. We welcome You. We welcome You. We welcome You. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, oh, oh. Glory, 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 glory.
Say this with me. Say, Lord, I can't breathe without You. Lord, I have no structure in my thoughts without You. Lord, I don't know where I'm going without You. Say, Lord, I'm defenseless without You. Say, Lord, You know my heart better than I know myself. You know how it betrays me. My heart longs to serve You, but then I do what I shouldn't. Forgive me, Lord. Wash me clean. The blood of Jesus. Wash me clean. I know today that the enemy would want me to think that I have no worth. But if that was true, Jesus would have never died for me. I know that the blood that He shed was because I was worth enough for Him to shed His blood. So in the name of Jesus, I take every thought captive that stands against the knowledge of Christ. And I declare tonight, I will not lose my opportunity.
I will not lose my
to receive from my Father.
To receive from my Father.
My arms are extended up.
My arms are extended.
My heart is open wide.
My heart is open.
My mind is surrendered to Him.
My mind is surrendered.
And I command my flesh.
And I command
to line up with His word.
To line up with His word.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Rise up within me.
Rise up within me.
I take these things.
I take these.
Captive.
Under the blood of the Lamb.
Under the blood of the Lamb.
I submit to God.
I submit to God.
I resist the devil.
I resist
and
the
I command him to flee.
I command him to flee.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Move in this place.
In this place.
I give You all authority.
I give You authority.
Oh, and I call You holy.
Holy.
And I am the righteousness of God.
Oh, now give Him praise in this house.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give Him praise in this house. is my Father, and I am His Son. I am His child. I am His daughter. All the glory to God. The devil is alive. He's not gonna beat me. I've already defeated him. He's under my feet. Greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world. I can't fight this battle in the flesh. I'm fighting this battle in the spirit man that is connected to my Father. Tonight, I lift up my praise. I lift up a shout. I give him all the glory because he's worthy. I said my God is worthy. Yes, my God is holy. Yes, my God is able. Yes, my God is willing. Yes, my God loves me. Yes, my God, hallelujah. He's my God. He's my God. Somebody shout it out. He's my God. Oh, he's my God. Hey. Oh. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You're my God. My God. My God. Oh, say this one last thing with me. Say, my God. Shout it like you mean it. Say, my God.
My God.
My God.
Is bigger.
Is bigger. In any circumstance.
Any circumstance.
My God.
My God.
Is bigger.
He's bigger
than any challenge.
Shout it out,
my God.
My God.
He's bigger.
He's bigger
than any sickness.
Than any sickness.
He's my God.
He's my God.
And I am his.
And I am his.
Oh, give him praise in this house. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Give him praise, give him praise. Yes, glory, 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 glory. Come on, if that was for me, that would have been all right. But I need you to give the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords a mighty praise tonight because he's worthy. Come on, give him praise. Hey! Glory, 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 glory. Come on, I want you to high five three people and say, I'm so glad you're in the house of the Lord tonight.
Praise the Lord. You may be seated, but we are so happy to have the Sotos here with us again, Hector and Anna. Anna, would you stand? We see Hector up front and center, and we were glad that y'all made it back here again. Praise the Lord. They're beginning to be like family, right? Amen. We want them more often than Thanksgiving. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're planning on having the Sotos here for a while every first of the month, first Wednesday and Thursdays of every month. So praise the Lord. Glad you came out to welcome them. Praise the Lord. And before he gets started, though, we're going to have our ushers come forward and receive tonight's offering, because I just want to give room at the end of the service for ministry. Hallelujah. And so I know God has a word. We've already been discussing back and forth where we feel like the Lord is leading. And so we've been praying for you tonight that the Holy Ghost, amen, delivers the message that he's formulating inside of Brother Soto tonight. Praise the Lord. So ushers, come forward, and we want you to just go ahead and prepare an offering to Grace Christian Fellowship, and we'll make sure that the Sotos are very blessed. They were highly blessed last time, and thank you, thank you, thank you so much for your offerings and love gifts, amen, to the Soto family. Praise the Lord. And let's see, grandson, is that right? Yes. Amen. How old now? Or just about? Okay. We're expecting July 3rd for their first grandbaby. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's wonderful. Praise God. And so this has been a wonderful, wonderful time with Sota. So praise the Lord. This time we're having them stay around Marathon and experience Marathonites. Amen. Hallelujah. And so they're enjoying their time around our home. Praise the Lord. Lewis, I believe you have a word to speak over the offerings. Remember, we are not droppers here. We just don't take your offering, just drop it in the hat, right? Amen. But we, by faith, speak over what God has invested in us. We're going to invest in His kingdom because the return is suspendous. It's great. It's mighty. God does mighty things. You can count the seeds in an apple, but you can't count what? How many apples there are in one seed, praise the Lord. So your seed tonight will multiply. That's just the way the kingdom of God operates. Hallelujah. I have found you cannot outgive God, no matter how hard. Shirley and I have tried. We just can't do it. He's always on the upside. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, Brother Lewis, would you pray over this offering, speak over these words, and you can speak with them if you want to bless your offering with them. Praise the Lord. Hold your offerings up.
Today I wrap my faith around my offering. As I release it into your hands, I speak increase, health, life, abundance, and favor on my family and on myself. I realize that my money is a seed, and by faith these declarations will fertilize to produce a great harvest. Thank you, Father, for all you have done and all you will do as I walk in obedience to your word today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord. All you ushers, go ahead and start receiving the tithes, offerings, gifts, seed sowing. Praise the Lord. Adam, you got a word?
And if you're like me and you don't carry cash and you want to use the iPad at the back, it's working tonight. I just gave that way. So I just want to give you that opportunity as well. And million is spelled M-I-L-L-I-O-N. Okay.
Wow. Praise the Lord. This is expanding your mind. Amen. That's transforming our minds. Praise the Lord. So I remember when I was a college student, man, it was something to give, you know, $1, $1.50, $2, $5. I mean, $5 was the big offering for me when I was a college student. But God has superseded that many times over in Shirley's my lives. And but God, again, I just can't outgive Him. He just keeps blessing us more and more and more and more and more. We can't catch up to Him. Praise the Lord. He's wonderful. His retirement plan is out of this world. Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Shirley, we had to send a letter off, I guess, to the jury duty or something for my mother. My mother died in March, you know. And Shirley was wanting to put on their return to sender. Patricia Williams, deceased, did not leave forwarding address. Isn't that neat? Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. She will be called for jury duty from now on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Pastor Hector, come on up. Y'all give him a hand. The man of God that we'll receive the word of God from tonight. Praise the Lord. Thank you for coming again.
Praise God. God bless everybody. Thank you. See, that was good. Y'all listen to her. God bless everybody. See? Now, who was more blessed, you or me? Amen. I got blessed by all of y'all. Amen. Praise God. Anyways, so glad to be back in the house of the Lord. Amen. So glad to be here with you. We've been very, very excited about coming, and here we are now. And God has opened up a door for us to come and visit and be a part of your family at least once a month. Amen. How long? I don't know, till Jesus says so. You know, or pastor gets tired of me. Praise God. Amen. But how could you get tired of this? That's what I want to know. How could anybody just, I'm just saying, Jonathan, how can you just get tired of this right here? This full package deal. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. This has been such a wonderful journey as the Lord has taken us from place to place and ministering a word. And we've seen the hearts of people impacted in such a beautiful way. How many of y'all were here the last time that we came, this past month? Last month when we came, how many of y'all were blessed with that word and that instruction and the things that God showed us? That was awesome. It was. I was blessed. I was preaching going, wow. Did that just come out of my mouth? It was awesome. Amen. And that's God's revelation for us. He wants to reveal himself to us. The closer that we draw to him, the more he draws into us. And he reveals himself to us every time that we call on his name. Are you with me? It's beautiful. Dios es fiel. Es maravilloso. Él es glorioso. La abundancia de Dios es más de lo que tú puedes concebir en tu mente. Su abundancia es maravillosa. His abundance is magnificent. His abundance is more than you can conceive in your mind. He's greater. He's deeper. He's wider. He's taller. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We can't scratch the surface of who he is. We can't reach with this little finite mind the understanding of who God is. People get perplexed just thinking that there is a kingdom that we've been brought into by adoption. What does that mean? We're so used to the natural, we don't understand the supernatural. And it's so funny because whether you see it or not, we go into the supernatural every service. And the key and what God is expecting for us is to actually go into the supernatural on a daily basis. Not just on a Wednesday night or a Sunday morning. If y'all remember the last time that I came, I told you every time you praise, you enter into a supernatural realm. Because in order for us to praise, he has to draw us unto himself. I even have the scripture today to show it to you. So every time you praise him, you're entering into a new realm, a realm where he abides in. You see, this fleshly realm is where you and I abide. But there is a realm where he abides at all times. And if we can learn to step into that, into the realm where he abides at all times, the atmosphere that we dwell in begins to change. And that's the place where miracles happen. That's where the flesh becomes still and quiet, and your spirit man wakes up. That's the place where the spirit man no longer has to battle with the thoughts of the flesh, but it is completely released and set free into a realm where all that matters and all that exists is him. See, just by the look of your eyes, you're going, What if the Word of God was teaching us to step out of the flesh and walk in the Spirit because His purpose for us was to call heaven on earth as it is in heaven? What if you are the key influencer in your circles of influence? And you're the one that should have the authority to speak those things that are not as if they were. What if the purpose of your existence was to praise God to a height that you could step outside of the natural boundaries of this world into the supernatural boundaries of heaven and move into the glory of God so that like Peter, Paul, John, Moses, Isaac, Elijah, who walked in the presence of God, we could see miracles happen. Your flesh will never produce the supernatural. No matter how hard you try, your flesh will never produce the supernatural. I am here to tell you tonight, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to talk about tonight and tomorrow is that you and I have been made in His image, and that you and I are one with Him. The flesh that you live in is simply a vessel that you occupy. But the truth of who you are, your identity, my identity is not a 150-pound man. Yo, some of y'all get it later. Y'all get it later. You're like, that man is not 150 pounds. I'm like, brother, you're bigger than that. I know you are. You're true. It's not funny. I'm speaking by faith. Come on. I'm prophesying over myself. Your true identity is not who you see in the mirror. Your true identity is the spirit that is inside of you, that God breathed into you. Can you say amen to that? All right. John 6 and 44. I'm going to give you 150,000 scriptures. So get ready. Just write them down, please. Just write chapter and verse. That'll be good. Amen. Book, chapter, and verse. And that you just read that at home. Find it at home. We start with John 6 and 44. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. And then I will raise him up on the last day. And I will raise him up on the last day. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me does what? Draws him. Jesus is saying, those that are going to seek me, Jesus is saying this, those that are going to seek me will not be able to seek me unless my Father allows them to see me. The revelation of who Jesus is did not come about because you had an epiphany all of a sudden. Oh, He's God. It didn't happen that way. Because your flesh will never recognize godliness. It doesn't. Jesus told the disciples, I think we talked about this the last time, could you not wake with me for 1 hour? Could you pray for me? Pray with me for an hour? Do you not? 3 times he came back. The third time he says, do you not understand that your spirit is willing, but your flesh is weak? Your flesh will never worship the Father. Just a little while ago when we were worshiping, how many of you were fighting with your flesh? Yeah, you were thinking about all kinds of stuff, all kinds of people, all kinds of junk. You were thinking about, man, I wish I could be watching the game right now. Like, did I lock the door? You were thinking about, you know, everything closes at 7. I'm hungry. You were thinking about all kinds of stuff. You were thinking about, well, I can't wait to get out of service. I'm going to tell him, give him a piece of my mind. I'm sick of him. You were thinking all kinds of stuff. And all of a sudden, the Spirit of God would hit you. This is how I fight my battle. Like a lightning bolt. Sometimes you got to throw yourself on the floor to make sure nobody sees you and you don't see nobody. Are you with me? All of a sudden, yes, right, you'll have to get before God because your flesh is always weak. It's always in the way. Are you with me? So when he says this, he says, listen, this is a key that you have to understand. Every time that you come before me, you're not drawing yourself because you can't. That's a really strong foundation. It's a foundational key to know that the only way we can come before the one who saved us is through the one who sent him. There's an order there. Do you see that? Yeah, there's an order. There's an order. And God is a God of what? He's a God of order. So there's a process that he works out. So this is something key. And I'm going to this because of what I'm about to establish with you. So he says, listen, no one come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. And I, now that was Jesus talking. Now I will raise him up on the last day. Those who identify with me, those who accept me, those who walk with me, those who live with me, he, they, and I will become one. And if I be lifted up, I will what? Draw all men unto me. What is he saying right here? He says, and I will raise him up on the last day. Amen. Are you with me? So what we're establishing here is this, that there is a process on how we come before the Father. And I want you to know this, that the only way to bypass your flesh is to submit to the Spirit of God. It's the only way. It's the only way to bypass your flesh. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, we are a spirit man wrapped in flesh. We are a spirit man wrapped in flesh. 1 Corinthians 6, 19 through 20. 1 Corinthians 6, 19 through 20. And this is what it says. And all of you know this scripture. I know you do. Or do you not know that your body is what? It's a temple. A temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God. Now here it is. Here's the revelation. You are not your own. Who do you belong to? Somebody say, I belong to my daddy. That's right. Who's your daddy? Jesus. God is your daddy. You belong to him. And how many of you know, if you were a good son, if you're a good daughter, and if you had a good daddy, when daddy would call you, what do? You come. You show up. He calls you to himself. He calls you into his presence. He brings you into his holiness. He brings you. And he's the one that created the venue. He created the open doors. He tore the veil from the top to the bottom. He's the one that allowed us access into the Holy of Holies. He called us unto himself and he provided the way for us to get there. Amen. All right? Do you not know that you're the body? That your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? Whom you have from God? Whom you have from God? Amen. You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. Now hear this. Glorify God in your body. It doesn't say glorify God with your body. The word of God is distinguishing here that there are two parts to you. Flesh and spirit. And there are three parts to your spirit. Or to your person, body, mind, and soul. You see that? He's being distinctive. And he's showing us right here because there is a great key that we have not allowed ourselves to adapt to. And guys, listen. How many believe that when we tap into the supernatural, supernatural things happen? And I'm not just talking about deliverance. I think that's a benefit. It's a benefit that we become delivered when we learn to draw into the presence of God. Because nothing that is unholy can live or dwell where holiness lives. What is holy and what is unholy cannot live together. Are you with me? So when we establish ourselves as holy, deliverance becomes an automatic benefactor for us. We become delivered because the spirit of the enemy cannot dwell where the spirit of God is. I would have shouted right there. I'm telling you right now. So here it is. I am believing God that these next 2 days, what we're going to talk about, is going to bring a supernatural movement into your mind, your heart, and your body. You're going to be able to see things like never before. And when you see these things, I believe that it's going to bring growth into this body. We're going to see all of these chairs, Pastor, packed. We're going to see them filled with hungry people who are wanting to know more of who our Father is. And they're going to recognize when the Father is calling them unto Himself, and they will come. You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. Here we go. Glorify God in your body. It is not your body that glorifies God. Who glorifies God in you? Your spirit man. It is your spirit man that glorifies God. Okay? Your flesh is simply a vessel. The Bible says that we are vessels with a treasure inside of us. Who is that treasure? It is the Spirit of God in us. Amen. That Spirit of God in us is what He considers His treasure. The understanding, listen to this. The understanding of love, the understanding of love is the core foundation of your spirit. The understanding of love is the core foundation of your spirit. If you can know what love is or who love is, then you will know how to deal and recognize the Spirit of God in you. Because love is not a feeling. It's a person. Love is a person. Love is God. He that does not know God does not know. Why? Because God is. God is. He doesn't have it. He doesn't feel it. He is love. He is the substance manifested of love. He is the fullness of love manifested. Anytime that love is in the room, God is in the room. Anytime that you tell somebody you love them, this is why you can't use that word. It's very, you know, breezy. You know what I'm talking about. I love you, girl. Love you. Don't even know what you're saying. Love you, girl. Shut up. You don't love me. You were talking about me yesterday. You say, love you, girl. Shut up. Amen. If you want to say that spiritually, say it in the King James Version. It says, shutteth uppeth. Oh, my Lord. Amen. Amen. Like I'm going to use that one. Shut it up. Don't you dare let people just use that love on you like it's nothing. And don't you dare use it like that either. That love is someone. You hearing this? You're allowed to say I love you to your husband. You're allowed to say I love you to your wife. You're allowed to say I love you to your children. And you're allowed to say I love you to people that you're connected to. Don't you dare just throw it out there like it's free. That's why I said breezy. He just said like it's breezy. Love you, man. Hey, love you. Oh, I do love you because we're connected. All right, hear this. He that does not know God does not know love, because God is love. He is. Look at what 1 Corinthians 13 says, this is the chapter of love. Everybody knows this. This is the chapter of love. But what we're going to do is we're going to take the word love in this chapter, every time we read it, and I want to introduce a new meaning to you. So that when you read it, maybe it'll give you a better understanding, a wider understanding. All right? When we see the word love, we're going to understand that that word love means the understanding that the Spirit of God dwells in me. Okay? The Spirit of God dwells in me. See, if I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not the Spirit of God dwelling in me. Are you seeing that? If I have not love, what does it mean? I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I don't have the Spirit of God dwelling in me, then I am a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. Do you get what I'm asking you to do here? And if I have a prophetic, if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not the understanding that the Spirit of God dwells in me, then I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not the understanding that the Spirit of God dwells in me, then I gain what?
Nothing.
Nothing. Because the understanding that the Spirit of God dwells in me allows me to be what? Patient. It allows me to be kind. The understanding that the Spirit of God dwells in me does not envy. It does not boast. The Spirit of God that dwells in me is not arrogant. It is not rude. It does not insist on its own way. And it is not irritable or resentful. What are we talking about? The Spirit of God. See, a lot of us love with our flesh. And what he's teaching us to do is to love with his Spirit. See, with my flesh, I am totally irritable. And you make me mad every time I see your eyes. And when I try to talk to you, you are arrogant, you're conceited, you're mean, you don't like me, I don't like you. Because that's what the flesh produces. He says, so you can do all of the nice things that you want to do, but if my Spirit doesn't dwell in you, you're not doing it the way you should do it. You're not loving people the way you should love them. Amen. You're not being me to them. Are you getting this? I'm going somewhere with this. Stay with me. Yes, so this is key. This is key. When you approach somebody with a need, do you approach them with your flesh to resolve the need? Or do you approach them with the Spirit of God inside of you to resolve the need? How do you do it? It should be the Spirit of God. But the majority of the time is with what? The flesh. How many of you all have seen a guy standing in the corner begging for money and your spirit man says, roll the window down, give him a couple of dollars. And your flesh is like, dude, he, no. Mm-mm. No. No. And it's weird because it has like an attitude. Oh, no. Mm-mm. No. Your spirit man will tell you, do it. Be Jesus to this guy. Be nice to this. Give him some food. And you're like, your flesh is always like, oh no, mm-mm. He looks dirty. Don't you hate it when people talk to you and their glasses go down? And you're like, are we getting this? There's a difference, all right? There's a difference in loving God with your flesh through your flesh, loving God with your spirit. Your flesh doesn't do a good job. Are you hearing me? Your flesh does not, and I'm just trying to establish the difference. It does not do a good job. All right, let's go a little deeper. Are you good with so far? So far with this? Okay, look at this. We are made in the image of Christ. Yes? We are made in the image of Christ. 2 Corinthians 3:18. 2 Corinthians 3:18. It says, and we all. Now, when it says we all, does that include the person sitting next to you? How many of you in your flesh would say, I hope not? If you think that way, you still need to get saved again. Because we're establishing here the difference. If your flesh is that loud, we need to crucify. All right, never mind. All right, here we go. And we all, the Bible says, and we all, with unveiled face. What does that mean? With a disclosed face. In other words, no masks. No hidden agendas. Are you with me? No fake smiles. No fake smiles. Unveiled face. Sister got it in the bag. Like, yeah, yeah. Look at this. With unveiled face, beholding the glory of God. Beholding the glory of God. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord. What is happening? We are being transformed. What does this mean? Transformed. Transformed. We are learning to trust in the Spirit of God. every day. Look at your neighbor and say, we're in a process of showing the flesh that it has no power or authority. And we are learning how to trust in the Spirit of God every day. Nobody has graduated except for Jesus. Oh, come on, give him praise for that. Amen. So this is what he's doing. He says, we are being transformed. We are learning to trust in the Spirit of God into the same image. We are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord. This comes from the Lord. Who ordained this process? The Father did. God did. This is his process for you and for me. Are you with me? His purpose is that we all learn how to come before him with an unveiled face. He wants us to learn to come before him with all of our faults, all of our weaknesses. He wants us to come and show up with every fault and every struggle. Why? Because the more that we reveal ourselves to him, the more he reveals himself to us. And we are transformed. From that thought process of hiding ourselves constantly to learning how to reveal ourselves before him so that what we reveal will be transformed. And we will be made into the image of who he is. His process is leading us to become more like him. And I believe, listen to this, I believe, and this is just Hector 101, all right? I believe that the process will be finished when the trumpets sound. Amen. And we are taken into glory. Hallelujah. Amen. I believe that's when the process will be finished. But every day we're in the process and we are pressing towards the mark, Paul. Every day we're trying to be more like who? Like Jesus. Every day we're trying to be more like him. Every day we want our spirit man to be more like him. Listen, get it out of your system. The only thing the flesh is going to do is be submitted. But the flesh will always be rebellious. Because the flesh is made of the dirt that was cursed by sin. The dirt, the flesh is made of the dirt that was cursed by sin. So your flesh will always be rebellious. This is why he told us, we don't walk by sight. We walk by faith. Amen. Are you hearing this? And faith cometh by hearing, and the hearing of the word of God. But it is not your flesh that is listening. It is your spirit man. Amen. And if you can learn to tap into the spirit man inside of you and declare things as the spirit man sees them and declare and speak those things that are not as if they were. You see, that is a supernatural term if there ever was one. He is telling you that though things may look in the natural a certain way, there is a man inside of you that can tap into the heavens and the glory of God and the power, hallelujah, of the resurrection. And he can tap into that and he can speak into those unnatural things, glory to God, and move them, change them. Transform them. Whenever you guys are all familiar with deliverance, whenever you come and there is somebody that is manifesting and going through a problem with some sort of a demonic issue, are you fighting against his flesh? No. You're fighting against that demonic thing that has entered illegally into the body of that person. How many of you know that we are not meant to have roommates? I'm just saying. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Okay, here we go. We are being transformed. We are learning to trust in the Spirit, into the same image from the one degree of glory to the another. For this comes from the Lord, who is Spirit. The Spirit of God, our Father, is who put this in motion, so that you and I might be able to draw closer to Him and be transformed as we draw near to Him. Are you with me so far? Romans 8:29. For those whom He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, in order that He might be the firstborn among many brothers. I want to establish this point this way. From the foundations of time, God knew that we would need a Savior. And His love for us has never changed from before the foundations of time, when we didn't even exist. His heart was already for us. Amen. So somebody say this out loud like you mean it. I've been loved for a long time. Isn't that good? You have been loved for a long time. There has been a plan in motion for you for a long time. God has established victory upon victory for you for a long time. God's mind for you and heart for you. This is why He tells us that He doesn't have harm in mind for us. He has good thoughts. He's got good things in plan and in store for us. Not to harm us, but to bless us, to prosper us. He spoke to His prophet and He says, before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. That word knew is intimacy. He was intimate with your spirit. He loved you way back before you had this vessel that we call flesh. And what He loved was not this 300-pound body. He loved the spirit man that He put inside of you. When you see Me, you're not looking at the outer man. When you see Jesus in me, you see the spirit man inside of me. And I may be looking like a 5'5" man on the outside, but the Spirit of God in me makes me a giant in the presence of the Lord, because greater is He that is inside of than he that is in the world. When you come against me, you're not fighting the flesh. Thou shalt not touch mine anointed. Ooh. He's not talking about my flesh. Thou shalt not touch that chubby man. That doesn't hold any power, guys. I can't rebuke a demon like that. Get thee behind my chubby body. It just doesn't resonate. There's no authority, no power. But when you say, in the name of Jesus, when you declare that the enemy has no authority and no power, and you say, get thee behind me, who I truly am. Get behind my identity. Get behind my source. Get behind my constant. Get behind my connection. Get behind my relationship. You get thee behind me, because greater is He that is in me. Amen. I am declaring this to you so that you can decide once and for all who you really are. Are you the spirit man that God breathed into your life? Or are you the man of flesh, ladies? Are you the man of flesh, gentlemen, that lives on this earth? The reason why we don't reach supernatural heights is because we're trying to jump up in natural bodies. And my flesh doesn't fly. Glory. Am I making you think? Yeah. I see some motors running. A few of them are kind of cobwebs is what I see flying. Chugga, 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 chugga. What do you think about that? Chugga, 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 chugga. I'm going somewhere. I'm almost done. Listen to this. Colossians 1 and 15. He is the image. He's talking about, we're talking about Jesus. He, Jesus, is the image of the invisible God. The firstborn of all creation. He is the image of the invisible God. I love this scripture. For me, it just feeds me to think. My mind goes like far, far, far into this. Because when I think, and growing up, you know, we hear these scriptures. We hear these scriptures, you know, that we are made in the image of God. Book of Genesis, right? We're made in the image of God. So I think that God is 5'5", chubby, and he's just real cute. That's how I see it, you know, and that's how I grew up thinking. But when I came to realize that my flesh, it doesn't line up with God's perfect word, then I thought to myself, how in the world is my rebellion made in his image? I think the heavens are just celebrating right now. They're going into overtime. Oh, sorry about that. How in the world can my flesh, my rebelliousness, be compared or line up with his holiness? It cannot. But in the spiritual realm, I am made in his image. Because my Father is a spirit. I am made in spirit, in his image. And every scripture that I've read to you right now, do you not know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit? Do you not know? Do you not know that the outer shell that you live in is not what he's after? Do you not know that when he calls us home, this flesh stays here? And who we truly are, which is spirit, will be returned unto him who is spirit. Dust to dust. Dust to dust. Dust to dust. But my spirit is returned unto him. I have had the privilege of seeing my mother go on to be with the Lord. I buried her body here on this earth. But I was there when her spirit left her body. And she left this earth glorifying and praising God. Her flesh was aching and hurting and ill because sin, curse of sin, produces sickness. And the dirt that was cursed still suffers from sicknesses. But the spirit man inside of her was free. I saw my father-in-law. My wife stood next to him as he was aching and ailing in his body. But there was a peace inside of him because the spirit man was connected to the Father and knew where his destiny was. The flesh rebelled and tried to hurt and ache. But when it was time for him to go, he began to raise up in tongues a voice that pierced through the room, filled the room. Corromo shataraba, herodo kosonde lemeka, brisonda rababasete, hidoro kosonda, and he slipped into eternity. Because your flesh may be bound, but your spirit will never be bound. And if you can take that understanding, no weapon forged against you shall ever prosper. Are you receiving this? No weapon forged against you shall ever prosper. Those who receive Christ in their hearts that are imprisoned, their flesh might be imprisoned. But the joy of the Lord has no prison that can hold it. This is why you have men that are incarcerated, that have life sentences, that are smiling as they go through the courtyards of the prison system and are still full of joy, because the flesh might have to pay the consequence. But because they have come to know their Father, who is the Spirit of the living God, who dwells in them, they are able to minister joy and peace, tranquility and victory in circumstances that are unforeseeable, that are difficult and challenging. They are able to speak life where death should be. Because the flesh is bound. The Spirit is free. Who is your spirit bound to? Who is your spirit bound to? Who are you tagged to? Who do you serve? And who do you love? Who is the one that is the constant in your life? Do you realize that the flesh will try to cling to other flesh so that joy might try to be birthed? Let that sink in for a minute. You try to find peace and joy in the person sitting next to you or in the person that's waiting for you at home. You try to find peace and joy in your coworkers or in your business. You try to find joy in the natural areas, the natural things of this earth. But isn't it funny that when we might find joy for a minute, it's only temporary? Amen. That is simply because everything that is bound to the flesh is temporary. Amen. Money is temporary. That 2019 will be old next year. Amen. Are you hearing this? Amen. But the Bible says that the blessings of the Lord are fresh and new when? Every day, glory to God. That does not wither. Your spirit does not wither. Your spirit does not decay. Your spirit is not full of sickness. Your spirit does not gain infirmities. Your spirit does not decline. It does not wither away. Your spirit is alive and alive forevermore. The moment you accepted the Spirit of God to enter into you and you were saved by the grace of the Lord, that moment your eternity already began. Your eternity already began. This flesh might be peeled away one day, but who you are will come out and be birthed, hallelujah, into existence for the rest of eternity. Okay, what time is it? 8:30. Y'all need to go to bed. Listen to this. They don't all feel like that. I'm just saying. Okay. This ain't God's time. You sit right there. I'm going to preach to you for the next 2 hours. There's so much more I want to give you. But let me establish this right now. I want to prove this to you. And I want you to know this beyond a shadow of a doubt. Okay. Let's go to Philippians chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2. This is my last scripture. Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 through 8. Glory, glory, glory. Do you sense the presence of God in this house? Do you sense it? There's an open spirit in here tonight, a learning spirit. You feel that? How many of y'all feel like a sponge right now? You're like, whoa. I need some more of that. What is that about? Just your spirit is saying, I need a little bit more of understanding on that. Look at this. Philippians. Lord, help us. Help us, Lord. Feed us, Lord. Philippians 2, 5 through 8. Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. I'm going to stop right there just for a second. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. I'm just going to get to the punch on this. He wasn't thinking with his flesh. Okay? Jesus was not thinking with his flesh. Jesus was not considering his flesh. He was thinking with the Spirit inside of him, the Holy Spirit in him, his spirit man. So he says, think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He was not using the flesh to think of himself. Are you with me so far? All right, look at this. For he had equal status with God. He had equal status with God. A lot of people say, well, of course, he was the Son of God. But it is not referring to his deity. It is referring to the spirit man inside of him. Because the same way that he was birthed, although his was through immaculate conception, he was birthed through flesh. So his spirit had to be placed in a body, just like your spirit had to be placed in a body. I am simplifying this the best that I can. The same way that Christ was brought into this world through flesh and blood, his spirit was placed in a body. The same way you and I were birthed. Our mama gave birth through us, to us through flesh and bone, flesh and blood. We were birthed. Our spirit was birthed that way. Are you with me? So when he says he had equal status with God, he's not talking about his flesh. He's talking about the spirit within him that is the same as his father's. Okay, here we go. But did not think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status no matter what. In other words, he knew that he was spirit in an earthly body. He knew that. He knew that he was God wrapped in flesh. He knew that. But he did not, in the time of trouble, in the time of challenge, in the transformation point, he did not call on 10,000 angels to come and rescue him. He dealt with this world in that fleshly body, in his spirit. His spirit dwelt in this world with that fleshly body to prove to you and to me that if he could do it, in the natural state that he was in, we could do it as well, just as he did. As a matter of fact, he became the example to us so that we would never have to test it again. Amen. You with me? You with me? What he was saying is this: I know the difference of who I am in him and who I am here on this earth. I know the difference. I walk on this earth, but I am connected to the heavens. Okay, okay, okay. When the time came, he set aside the privileges of deity and he took on the status of a slave. He became human. Having become human, he stayed human. And it was an incredibly humbling process. And he did it. He did not claim special privileges. Instead, he lived as a selfless, obedient life and then died a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death at that, a crucifixion. Okay. Think of yourself as Jesus thought of himself. I have a question for you. Actually, I have four questions for you. Number one, how many of you know that God is a blesser and not a curser? He will not curse you. How many of you know that he abides in you? The same Spirit of God is the same that formed the heavens and the earth, that spoke things into existence, is the same God that lives in you. How many of you know that when you tap into that spirit, all the fullness of the authority and the wholeness of who God is activated? Are you with me? So that means that if God produced with his words, you can produce with your words too. There are theories out there that God brings challenges to his children. I don't know that I agree with that. Because my God is a blesser and not a curser. And if He is the God that dwells in me, why would God curse Himself? And call it a teaching. Call it a lesson. Well, He needs to be humbled. I want you to hear this as I say this. Hear it very, very clearly. The devil is a lie. Amen. He that dwells in you, He that abides in you, will draw Himself to Himself. Amen. This is why He does that. When He calls you unto Him, the Spirit that is Him already dwells in you. So when He needs a little of Himself, He grabs a hold of you. And He says, me, come to me. Amen. And He unites with Himself. He connects with Himself. And He brings life to Himself in you. Amen. God would never curse Himself. The Bible says that God would tempt no man. As a matter of fact, when temptation comes, He provides what? The way out. Right? The way of escape. The way out. He provides it. Why? Because He would never tempt Himself. What kind of a God would He be? If He would tempt Himself to prove to your flesh that He is God. That's ridiculous. Do you hear me? That's ridiculous. He would never put you in a circumstance where temptation was your weakness to see if you would choose Him and not temptation. I'm just going to say it like this. Back at home, they said, that's stupid. Can I say it in the King James Version? Thus is stupideth. That just makes no sense. Are you with me? Because God is not a tempter of Himself. And if He is not a tempter of Himself, then He would never tempt you. Because you are. God would never make you beg. He will never make you beg. He did not create you to plea bargain with Him. He did not create you to beg Him for an answer. He did not create you to beg him for a solution. He did not create you to put you in a corner in a circumstance that will cause you to fall over in a fetal position because you have no hope. Waiting for an answer to show up. That is not the God that we serve. Because God would never ask Himself to beg Himself for something that He already provided from the foundations of time. Amen. He is the God of all the silver and the gold. That means that you are the inheritor of all the silver and the gold. He provided His Son to die on a cross, to shed His blood, to take 39 stripes on this flesh, so that your spirit man would have the connection and the authority to proclaim and claim the salvation and the healing that He provided on that day. You don't have to beg Him to heal you. You are the healed of the Lord. Lord, please. Don't you ever say, Lord, please. You say, Lord, thank you. Yes. Oh, come on. Your whole prayer life will change when you understand that everything you have need of has already been set in motion. It's already been provided. Do you not realize that the God that is inside of us is the same God that was there in the beginning, before the foundations of the world and before you existed? He saw into the future to where you were and the need you had, and he provided the blood of his son so that you could connect to him, and he walked further into your future, and he opened his arms and he said, I'm waiting for you. Just keep coming to me. Hallelujah. Everything you have need of is along the way. Well, I need more money. No, you need more God. Amen. You need more understanding. Well, I need a better house. No, you need to know that he's the one that makes the home. No. But I need more provisions. No, you need more understanding that nothing, hallelujah, that you ask for is being held back from you. It's already been provided. Amen. Ask not. Don't ask him. Thank him. And require it. The devil will tell you, how dare you? How dare you demand that from the Lord? You're just a little old peon. You're just a somebody who's a nobody. That's who you are. How dare you come before? I'll tell you how. I may be short in stature, but I am huge in my spirit, because I am connected to the one who breathed life into me. I am connected to the one who spoke the stars into the existence. I am connected, hallelujah, to 1,000 cattle on 1,000 hills. He is my blesser, my provider, my Jehovah Jireh. I have no need, because he is my fulfiller. He is, hallelujah, in me, and I am in him. Your flesh does not think that way. Your flesh doesn't think that way. Your flesh thinks, oh my God, I gotta work 10 more hours. So, oh man, I gotta go to work again. Oh my God. God has provided ways for us to attain our funds. Our way of living. He's a provided way. And he's the strength inside of you that will allow you to accomplish that path. But I want you to hear this. Your sustainment and your blessing is not in that 8-to-5 job. Your blessing and your sustainment is not in the title that you hold. Your blessing and your sustainment is not in who you connect with up the ladder in your workforce. No, your sustainment is in the one who made you, who breathed life into you, who connected with you and said, I am in you and you are in me. We are one. Because if you don't like that job, you just tell daddy, he'll get you another one. Are we thinking different? Are we seeing different? Anybody? One? Two, three, four, five, six? Good. Good. This is why, Pastor, I close with this. I'm done for real now. My flesh lies. I tell you, my flesh. My flesh lies. My spirit man is like, listen. This is why, hear me now, this is why the tithe is holy. If you're not tithing, hear me tonight. If you're not tithing, hear me. If you're not tithing, you say, oh my God, you're going to talk about money? No, I'm talking about a covenant. Oh my God, you're going to tell me to give my 10%. It's not yours. It's his. This is why it's holy. Because every time the Bible says in the book of Malachi that he will rebuke the devourer, he will heal your land, and he will restore you. Amen. When you bring the tithe, it is a spiritual covenant. Hear me now. We're going somewhere. It is a spiritual covenant that you declare to be true between you and the one who made you. That 10% binds you to your father. This to my father says, we're one. We're one. I believe in you. I trust in you. Everything you said about me, I know it's true. I will stand in that promise. I will stand on your word. And though my flesh may rebel, my spirit is bonded to you. And I prove it going against everything in my flesh to do it. I prove it by giving you what is yours. Amen. It becomes a love covenant. Are you with me? Yes. A love covenant. That love covenant calls his protection and his provision, because he will never abandon himself to the works of the enemy. I will rebuke the devourer. Notice that he didn't say, you rebuke the devourer. He says, I will rebuke the devourer. If the enemy has intruded in your life, if the enemy has taken from you, if the enemy has tempted you and you've fallen, if the enemy has made you feel like you're not worthy enough to require, but you're lowly enough to beg, if the enemy has made you feel that the struggles that you've been facing is because God is against you and not for you, you have not yet understood your identity. And tonight I am here to reveal to you, you are the blessed of the Lord. You are blessed and highly favored. You have been knitted by the hands of God. He weaved your life and formed you and framed you out of the works of eternity. And he has made you into the image of himself. You are a temple of his Holy Spirit. You abide, hallelujah, inside of an earthly vessel. But you are not of this world. You belong to the God who made you. You're a citizen of heaven, called unto righteousness. You are not, hallelujah, broken down, forgotten, and abandoned. You are loved. You are called. You are established. You are favored. You are the blessing of God. And he who abides in you is greater than he that abides in the world. Rise up in the mighty name of Jesus. Declare who you are. Rise up tonight and say, I am a child of the living King. I am a child of the living God, and he that abides in me, hallelujah, forever he will receive the praise. Amen. Stand. Every eye closed. Do you see it? Do you see who you are? Do you see who you are? Does this mean that I can say those things that are not as if they were? Yes. Does this mean that because God has never lost a battle, I am victorious? Yes. If this means that he is the owner of everything on this earth, does that mean that I have access to everything on this earth? Does this mean that when I tap into the spiritual realm, through his Holy Spirit, my spirit man can connect with the heart of the Father, and things around me, atmospheres around me, can change? Mamas, mamas, hear me. Every eye closed, mamas, hear me. Does this mean that when I pray in the Spirit, I can speak over my children? And though my flesh is bound geographically to one spot, my spirit can move to and fro and touch the heart of God, who in turn touches my children. You may not be in the same car, but your spirit is. Does this mean that when the enemy rises up to steal from my land, the God who is the defender, the protector of my life, will build a hedge of protection around me, and nothing that the enemy touches shall be his? And should anything be lost because of the God who is in me, it must be returned sevenfold. You are not your flesh. You are the Spirit of God, the identity of God in your flesh. Hands lifted as high as you can. And I want you to tap into the Spirit of God. If you can speak in holy tongues, then go ahead and do that. If you don't know how to speak in tongues, just begin to speak in the Spirit of the Lord. Father, I acknowledge you, that you dwell in me. I acknowledge that you are my God and that you abide in me. In the name of Jesus, I command my flesh to submit to the Spirit of God inside. I command my flesh to keep silent inside of me as I speak to my Father. Oh, my life is a witness that declares unto the Lord, I am the servant of the Lord whom you have chosen, that you may believe and know and understand that I am He. Before me, God says, there was no God formed, nor shall there be any other after me. Inside of you dwells the fullness of the deity body inside of you. Sharadaka hase. Tap in. Tap in. Tap in. Tap in right now. Tap in. Tap in. And begin to declare these things. You are my God. I am your servant. I am your child. No weapon forged against me shall prosper. Greater is he that lives in me than he that lives in the world. I have been called for greatness. I am not bound by this flesh. I am free in the Spirit of God. And I declare right now, flesh, you listen to me. I bind you and your activities and your rebelliousness. Sickness, I command you to leave now. Aches and pains, you go now. Migraine headaches, you go now. Arthritis, you go now. High blood pressure, you know now. You go now. Diabetes, you go now. Lusts of the flesh, you go now. I command you by the Spirit of the living God that dwells in me. I am not bound by you. I am set free. And the Spirit of the God is in me. And he whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You have no authority over me. My spirit submits unto God. I resist the devil, and he must flee. In Jesus' mighty name, every challenge is bound. Every demonic presence is bound. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let's set the Spirit of God free. Set him free. Set him free. Let the Spirit of God in you free. Let the Spirit of God in you free. Release it now. Release it now. Release it now. Brasandarama de cosa. Ela rabacambre sendere de becora. Kembra sherarabade de sondarabaca. I am a vessel of the living God. He and I are one. He and I are one. His spirit abides in me. And I have the authority of the living God inside of me. I give him glory. I give him praise. I exalt him. And I give him all the honor. Oh, because only he is worthy. Only he is worthy. Can you just love him for a moment? Love him for a moment. Just love him. Love him. Love him. Love him. Love him. Say, Father, I receive this revelation. I receive this revelation. I receive this explanation. And I call it real in my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you praise, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Be free in the name of the Lord Jesus. The Holy Spirit sends forth the Word of God to heal and to deliver. Amen. And if you've prayed with Pastor Hector, if you prayed with him for freedom, if you prayed with him to be delivered, if you prayed with him to be healed, if you prayed with him, hallelujah, to be blessed, hallelujah, if you'll speak it with your mouth, if you'll believe it with your heart, you shall be healed, set free, made whole, delivered, amen, and blessed, hallelujah. That's what sozo is all about, salvation in the Lord. It says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Amen. And that's how we fight our battles. Amen. That's how we fight the battles that we have to have. And this is the victory which overcometh the world, even your faith. Amen. And so you got to use your mouth. Amen. To get your faith engaged. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. If there's anyone that needs further prayer, counseling, a word, you feel like that there's something else that you want from the Lord, I want you to step forward up here. And we do have some announcements for the ladies and the men. This Saturday is a powerful time because, men, we have bacon this Saturday morning, okay? And that really gets the guys to breakfast at 8 o'clock. After 8, we finish up. 9, by the way, not only do we have bacon, but we have Luis Hernandez will be sharing some word on Saturday morning. And he's already described some things. So praise God. You need to hear this man. Amen. He's my man of steel. Hallelujah. He drives a bus all the way to Columbus, Texas and back. That's a man of steel. Amen. Hallelujah. Also, the women, surely you have some announcements for the women this Saturday. Women, this is for y'all.
Okay, so in the back, you're going to see a couple of handouts. So one of them is for Saturday. It's healing for the spirit, soul, and the physical body. The event will be held at the Wellness Center. And by the way, Joe, you look sharp. Boy, what happened to you? It's like, who is that? Thank you, Jesus. Looks like somebody came to church tonight. So anyway, but it'll be just a day of blessing for all of the women. So men are not allowed, but women, please come. And it is a day full of incredible events. My mom's actually going to be sharing as well. She's going to share some really important nuggets for the women. But yeah, there's a whole lot of gifts. We have a makeup artist flying in to give us tips on looking better. So massage therapy, we will have two massage therapists there, essential oils, frequency therapy, lymphatic drainage, relaxation therapy. I'm telling you, foot bath, sauna. Y'all, this is going to be an awesome event, so please do not miss it.
Guys, I don't see bacon there.
Yeah, from 10 to 2. We'll watch it. Sinead's probably going to bring it, so... anyway, y'all, there's a whole lot of gifts. It's just an incredible event. Please come. And then Sunday is Mother's Day. Hallelujah. Amen. So, yay! We would not be here if it wasn't for your mama. Okay. So, anyway, Sunday will be a day of blessing. Ladies, we need everybody here because it'll be a day where the women take over. All right. So the women will be helping and taking care of so many things. We've also been really blessed to have a chef that will be here Sunday. And so we will have a wonderful meal for everybody. And if you are able to give a donation, all the donations will go towards camp for the summer camp for this year. And if you're not able to give a donation, we have some people that are sponsoring your meals. And if you can't find a sponsor, we want you to stay and eat anyway, okay? So that means nobody gets to go hungry. So everybody, we want everybody to be here. So please look in the very back, Evelyn. So where Evelyn's at, if you'll pick up one of each and make sure that we have these in your hands. If you have more that maybe you can share some at the office, please grab some and hand them out at school, at the office, around town, around the surrounding towns, because we want the women to be blessed. This is a weekend of Mother's Day celebration. You know, some people celebrate it one day. Y'all, we're just going to take the whole weekend. So anyway, we want the ladies to be blessed. So thank you.
Amen. Let's be dismissed. Shake someone's hand you don't know. And if you do want further prayer, we want you to feel free to